This problem we're going to look at an adiabatic semibatch reactor in which we have a liquid phase reaction, A plus B goes to C. And so the reaction is first order in A and first order in B. And we're going to start the reactor out containing only reactant A, and it's at 25 degrees C. And then we're going to add reactant B, which is at 50 degrees C. We're going to add at a flow rate of 10 moles per minute until we've added 500 moles, namely 50 minutes. And so we've added a stoichiometric amount of B. And then we stop the flow rate of B. And what we want to do is plot how the temperature changes as a function of time and how the number of moles of A, B, and product C changes as a function of time up to 120 minutes. I'm giving the heat capacities, the heat reaction, and the rate constant, and how it depends on temperature. So the first thing I want to do with this problem, and with most reactor design problems, I want to draw a diagram of the system and label what we know. So I've drawn a representation showing the initial conditions in the reactor, the feed conditions. Keep in mind, we only feed this for 50 minutes and then we stop the flow into the reactor. Now, unknowns, the number of moles of A, capital N, number of moles of B, number of moles of C, and the temperature in the reactor, all of these as a function of time. And so what we want to write down first are mole balances for this system. And we're going to write, since we're going to solve this numerically, we're going to write mole balances for each of the components. This is the easiest way to do this. The change in the total number of moles of A in the reactor with time is the rate of reaction. Now, the rate of reaction is minus K, the concentration of A, this rate of reaction times volume, number of moles on the left, has to be number of moles on the right, so times volume. The change in number of moles of B with respect to time, it's going to have two terms. One, we're flowing B into the reactor. That's the molar flow rate, 10 moles per minute. And then we're reacting B at the same rate that react A because of stoichiometry. So rate of reaction times volume. Now, this is only true for T less than or equal to 50 minutes. For longer times, then, the change in number of moles of B with respect to time is just R sub A times the reactor volume. So this is for time greater than 50 minutes. We have now a similar equation for the number of moles of C with respect to time. Rate of C times volume. Well, the rate of C is minus the rate of A. One mole of A reacts, we make one mole of C times volume. And then the final, not a mole balance, but relates to this, is the change in the volume of the reactor. So we're adding 1 liter per minute, so that's V0. So the volume is increasing with time. This affects the concentrations, affects the rates of reaction. We have to take that into account. Then we need initial conditions for these differential equations. The number of moles of A initially is 500. The number of moles of B initially is 0. Likewise, the number of moles of C initially is 0. And the volume initially is 50 liters. So next thing we want to do is write down the energy balance for this system. Energy balance needs to take into account the flow into the reactor and the heat of reaction. Reactor temperature is changing, and what we need to do is, in this case, we're heating up all the contents. So number of moles of A times the heat capacity of A, number of moles of B in the reactor, which of course is a function of time, times the heat capacity of B, and number of moles of C, the derivative of temperature in the reactor as a function of time. So we have the flow rate of B into the reactor times the heat capacity of B, the temperature inlet minus the reactor temperature. So when the inlet temperature is higher than the reactor temperature, we're increasing the temperature in the reactor. When it's lower as reaction proceeds, then we're providing some cooling, if you like. And then we have the heat of reaction term, so the heat of reaction times the rate of reaction times volume. And then in general, we're going to have a heat transfer rate, but since this is adiabatic, this term is zero. And again, we can look at the signs to make sure we've written this correctly. Heat reaction, exothermic reaction, is negative. R sub A is reacting away. This is a negative term. So overall, this is a positive term, which means it's going to increase the temperature and increase the derivative that's on the left side. So with the energy balance, then I just need the other equations, because in our rate expression, I have a concentration. Well, I need to determine that concentration. And it's a function of number of moles, which is changing, and the volume, which is also changing. And the exact same thing for B, the number of moles divided by the volume. The only other thing I need, well, I need an initial condition for this energy balance. And that's T0 is equal to 25 degrees plus 273, to put it in Kelvin. And then I need some constants. So those constants, and of course we also need the rate constant, 1.7 times 10 to the fourth e to the minus 10,000 over RT, where 10,000 is in calories per mole, so we use the R value of 1.98. Temperature is an absolute temperature. If we also wanted to calculate the fractional conversion, Na0 minus Na over Na0 would give us the fractional conversion, number of moles initially in the reactor of A minus the number at a later time. We're not adding any A, so we can calculate the conversion for A this way. Now we have everything we need to solve this numerically. I'll show you the results of a polymath solution, and then in a separate screencast show you the polymath solution. And so here's the output from the polymath program that solves the differential equations. Number of moles of A decreases. That decreases continuously. The number of moles of B increases as we're adding B, but then as the rate accelerates, the number of moles decreases, and then at this point we stop adding B. This is the number of moles of C. The temperature increase, because it's exothermic as the reaction proceeds and it's adiabatic, temperature goes up, so the rate accelerates, and therefore the number of moles of A and B start dropping dramatically when the temperature is increasing. In a separate screencast, I'll show you the polymath program that was used to generate these plots.